There is no other option. It is either success or death. There is no other option. There isn't. Just don't stop. Today we're going to talk about probably the most stereotypical shit that you could talk about in a motivational podcast, and that is how to change your life. But let's dive into it. Let's talk about how to change your life. I want to talk right to the core of you. And as I'm talking to you, I want you to actually think, who am I as I'm going through this? Am I person A or am I person B? And I'm going to talk about how to change your life in one simple moment, and that becomes a decision that you decide to make in your life. And, you know, one of the things that I really see that hold people back from the life they want, the happiness they want, the success they want, the money they want, the marriage they want, the relationship with their children that they want, is 100% full commitment, no other options, into what that one thing is. It requires full commitment. No toe dippers. You got to jump in. And last night I was over at a friend's place and we decided to do a cold plunge. And it was me and then two of my friends. And we would say relatively successful entrepreneurs run successful businesses. And we're talking about, you know, how it's cold. It's probably about 40 degrees inside of the pool. It's probably about 40 degrees outside of the pool. And we're talking about, should we walk down the stairs or should we jump in? And all three of us are like, the stairs. Why would we do that? Let's cannonball it. Not jump in. Let's cannonball it. Let's force ourselves to just jump into the deep end and just do it. Instead of dipping our toes in and seeing how the water feels, nobody touched the water to see how it felt. Nobody walked down the stairs to get there. Everyone went full commitment and just cannonball in that freaking pool. That's what we decided to do. So when you think about that, I want you to think about how that relates to your life and the decisions that you do or don't make. Do you kind of commit to stuff? Do you start things and then give up on things because it's not going the way that you want within the first week, 2 weeks, 4 weeks, month, 4 months? Are you somebody who starts things and then gives up on them too soon? I want you to ask yourself, are you that type of person? Yes or no? Because here's what I've learned in life. You have to decide what you want and you have to fully commit. There are no other options. You have to do this one thing. It requires full 100% commitment. There is no other option. It is either success or death. That's it. You either succeed or you die trying. There are no other options. There is no, well, I'll give it a shot for 2 weeks. Well, I'll give it 6 months and see how it works. It is, I will figure it out no matter what. I will do it. And if I have to wait until I'm 85 years old, you know, the next 60 years of my life will be dedicated to mastering this one thing. I have to burn the boats. And I don't know if it's a true story about burning the boats, but whether it's true, not true, it's an amazing parable. And the story behind it is that there's a Spanish conqueror and he goes across the Atlantic Ocean. And he notices as he's going across the Atlantic Ocean, his people on the boat, they're not really fully committed. Like they seem like they kind of want to go back home. They're not really sure if they're going to be able to conquer the next land that they're going to. And when he gets there, they're all on wooden boats. When he gets there, he says, all right, everybody, we've landed. I want you to go ahead and burn all of our ships, burn the boats that we came here on. Everyone's like, why would we do that? But how are we going to retreat? He goes, there is no retreat. There is no other option. You have to burn the boats. Either we succeed and we conquer this land or we are going to die on this land. There is no going home. Because when you make that decision, you're going to go full force into whatever it is. Okay, I don't want to die. And so I'm going to go and I'm going to try to conquer whatever it is that I need to conquer. You know, one of the things that we were also talking about before we did the cold plunge is we were in the sauna and we were talking about success and how we got to the point that we're at and all of our businesses and all this stuff. And one of the things that was asked is, why do you think that you've succeeded? And each one of us went around, we were in the sauna for an hour. Why do you think that you have succeeded? And each one of us went around and said why we think we've succeeded. And I said, there's really two things for me. Number one, I'm not afraid to start something new. I'm completely cool with it. And number two, when I decide to do it, I just don't stop. Like nothing will stop me. My best friend said the thing that he appreciates most about me in business is like I'm a cockroach. I just figure it out, I decide to do it, and I'm just not going to die. I'm gonna just keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going. And then I decided to do 900 podcast episodes almost of this podcast, but it took about 700 podcasts before it exploded. So are you willing to put in 700 podcast episodes to succeed or the equivalent of that in whatever it is that you wanna do? Are you willing to put everything that you have into it to succeed or to die? And it's the idea of going, I don't know anything about this thing that I want to succeed at. Whatever it is for you, but I'm gonna put every ounce of energy into doing it. Could you imagine? Let me just take success out of it, but let's talk about marriage or relationships, right? Could you imagine if you decided to, you know, get married, but then as you get married, you're like, yeah, but I'm also gonna keep this woman on the side just in case this one doesn't work out. Is that marriage actually going to succeed if you have a side piece just in case the other one, you know, you keep someone on the side? Of course not. How does a marriage succeed? How does a relationship succeed? This is my person. I'm going to fully 100% commit, and that is the only option. That's how it succeeds. That's how everything succeeds. Not just success and business and all of that stuff, but in relationships and your friendships, you have to put everything that you have into it. You know, if you think about something that you've done that you've succeeded at, I guarantee you weren't good at it when you first started, but you made the decision up of, I'm just going to keep going. I remember watching a podcast episode, a video on YouTube where Jared Leto was being interviewed. And I've talked about it so many times because it really just hit home for me. And Jared Leto, if you don't know, he is an incredible actor. He's also an incredible musician. He's also an incredible artist. Like, so he succeeded at a very, very high level in many different aspects of his life when most people might not even succeed at one of those things, and they want to succeed at those. And the person who was interviewing him said, what do you think makes you different than other people? And he's like, when I was young, I noticed that most people just don't start. And if I started whatever it is that I wanted to do, I would already be light years ahead of everybody else. And then the next thing I noticed is that most people stop along the way. And I just decided to myself, if I'm going to start something, I am going to go full force at that thing, and I'm not going to see anything else as an option except for succeeding at that. And so I ask you, when you decide to start something, are you dabbling? Are you a dabbler? Are you a toe dipper? Do you just kind of try it out for a little while and see if it works? Because that never works. Do you think LeBron James became one of the best basketball players ever because he played basketball Monday through Friday when he was younger and then also played volleyball just in case basketball didn't work out? No. What did he do? Full 100% commitment into his craft, basketball. The crazy thing about life is that you don't have to be good at 99.99999% of things in the world. You just have to master one thing. And if you master one thing, you will see the success that you want. The question is, what is that one thing? Is it painting? Is it videography? Is it music? Is it playing basketball? Is it being the best coach that you could be? Is it being a successful business owner? Is it being the best freaking mom that you could be? Whatever it is, when you decide to fully commit 100% is when you will see success. Now, will success happen right away? No. The universe likes to test you a little bit to see how bad you actually want it. But when you fully commit and say, this is my thing, that's when you will fully see the success that you want. Hey, if you're enjoying this video, do me a favor and hit that like button down below. It helps with the YouTube algorithm so that more people can see this message because it helps us get it out organically. So hit that like button and I appreciate you. For me, I didn't know anything about podcasting. I just said, you know what? I'm going to start a podcast and I'm not going to stop. I will figure it out because if I f*** up enough, I'll eventually figure out how to stop f***ing up and I'll start doing it better, right? When I started creating viral videos on Facebook, I knew nothing about social media. I knew nothing about Instagram. But, you know, if you fast forward, I put everything that I could into it. Now we're at like 1.5 billion views across Facebook, right? That just doesn't happen. It comes from full commitment. You know, if you look at coaching people, I didn't know anything about coaching people, but I decided a decade ago, I'm just going to figure out what it is that makes me tick and what makes other people tick and how I can get better at it. I'm going to fully commit. And it's almost as if God or the universe or the powers to be or whatever it is that's holding this whole universe and the, you know, the world and the universe and everything that's surrounding us and the Milky Way and the stars, whatever's holding all of this stuff together, what it's looking for and what it's waiting for is your full commitment. And if you half-ass commit to somebody or half-ass commit to something, it's not going to send you all of the energy and the powers that you need to create the thing that you want to create, to make the life that you create. But when you fully commit, when you decide that there is no other option and I'm going to succeed or I'm going to put effort forth every single day until the day I die to get better at this thing and there are no other options, it's like the universe clicks over and says, all right, let's freaking play. Let's do it. Let's do it, man. Now that you've committed, now I'm going to send the resources your way. If you've decided that there are no other options, you're going to succeed or you're going to try dying and you're going to die trying, you're going to put every ounce of energy into it, it's like all of these synchronicities start happening. The people that you need come into your life like magic. The opportunities come into your life like magic. The places that you need to go to, you start going to, and you see the people, you see the opportunities, and everything starts to work in your favor. When you fully commit, the universe goes, all right, dude, let's play this game. I see how it is. I'm going to show you what I can do. But it'll test you a little bit, how bad you actually want it. You'll see some success. You'll see some failure. It'll throw those failures at you to see if you are actually truly 100% committed. I can't explain it. I don't understand it, but I know it's true. I know it's true for my life. I know it's true from a lot of friends' life. I know it's true from studying successful people and reading autobiographies of people who have succeeded and made amazing things in this world. I know it to be true. So my question to you is, how have you been your entire life? Have you been a toe dipper? Or have you been the person who cannonballs in the deep end? Which one have you been? You have to realize, if you've been a toe dipper, I have a question for you. How's that been working out for you? Are you where you want to be as a toe dipper? Do you have the life that you want as a toe dipper? Are you proud of what you've created as a toe dipper? Or does it feel like something's missing? Does it feel like you're not really there? Does it feel like there's another level for you? Do you feel like there's more potential that you need to bring out of yourself? You're not going to get to your full potential until you get your full commitment to whatever it is that you're trying to get to. And when you decide that you're going to go at one thing and you're going to master one thing, you'll start to see yourself improve and get better and get better and get better and get better of whatever it is that you're trying to improve at. The universe will come to your side, you will come to your side, and you will start to realize that your life starts to line up in ways that you've never thought was actually even possible. It's like Will Smith says, there's no reason to have a plan B because it distracts from plan A. Let me say that again, there is no reason to have a plan B because it distracts from plan A. You've heard the phrase, don't put all your eggs in one basket. No, put all your eggs in one basket and watch that freaking basket all day long and put every ounce of energy that you can into that basket. It's how the life works. It's how the universe works. It's how it all works. It's how success works. It's how happiness, joy, peace, whatever it is that you want. That's how you get what you want. You have to decide that this is what I'm going to do. Now, I understand there's some people that are out there and you're like, well, this is great and all, but I don't even know what I want. Okay, well, first off, you have to give yourself permission to dream and to figure out what that is. Because I've found for a lot of people that I've worked with over the years is that their sense of creativity of growing up is diminished as they get older because it's almost like it's unprogrammed out of you. And you're like, I don't even know what I want anymore. I'm 34, 35, 40, 45 years into my life and I don't even know what I want anymore. I've just been following what it feels like I'm supposed to do. And then I'm sitting here and I'm like, I don't want to be here anymore, but I also don't know what I want. I'm going to tell you what I always say. If you've been listening for a while, you've heard me say it. I'm going to say it again and again and again. It's okay to not know what you want right now. It's all right. It's okay. But it's not okay to not be in constant pursuit to find out what that thing is and work for it every single day once you do find it. So if you don't know what it is that you want, cool, no worries. But you need to spend every single day until you figure out what it is to find out exactly what it is that you want. And once you do figure out what it is that you want, you need to spend every ounce of energy into making that your life, into making that a part of you. That's what you need to do. So going back to the original question, when you look back on your life, do you see a bunch of full commitments or do you see a bunch of toe dipping? If you see a bunch of toe dipping, I guarantee you're not at the place of your life where you want to be. If you were to see a bunch of full commitments, I guarantee your life would be at the place that you would want it to be. Your life, you have created something beautiful. You've created something amazing. And that's awesome. But if you look back and you see, man, there's just a bunch of toe dipping. There's a bunch of starting and giving up and starting and giving up and starting and giving up. Well, then that's why you're not where you want to be. It's not that you haven't found what you truly want. It's that you just haven't fully committed to something. You will not succeed toe dipping. Have you been toe dipping? How's it been going for you, man? Probably not so good, right? So, here's the thing. It all starts with the decision. What is it that you want? Figure out what it is that you want. Go at that thing that you want. Hardcore. Make the decision, and then you say to yourself, there is no other option. I will either succeed at this thing, or I am okay spending the rest of my life working to become the best that I possibly can at this thing. Whether it's being the best mom that you can be, being the best dad that you could be, being the best spouse that you could be, being the best parent that you could be, being the best CEO that you could be. Whatever it is that you want, you have to decide that you're going to be the best you possibly can. You have to go, this is it. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to burn the boats. There is no other option. There isn't. I'm going to succeed, or I am going to die trying at succeeding at whatever this thing is. So now I ask you this question. Are you ready to commit? Are you ready? Are you ready to stop toe dipping? Are you ready to jump in the deep end? Are you ready to commit? You have to decide what it is that you want in this world. You have to put every ounce of energy that you have into it. God, the universe, whatever it is, will come to your side. And then here's the secret. Just don't stop. Hey, thanks so much for watching this video. If you want to learn even more about mastering your mind, click right here and watch this video as well. Hard work is hard. Being broke is hard as well. Because you either sacrifice now or you sacrifice later. What sacrifice do you want?